Good morning, viewers. It's a new day. Welcome to today's devotion with The Daily Fountain, the devotional guide of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. Invite your family and friends, get your Bible and your Daily Fountain manual while our devotional leader takes us on today's devotion.
This morning, we are going to look at the topic that says, "Come nearer." Let us pray. O God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning for bringing us together in your presence. Thank you for waking us up. Thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for your assurance this day, which you've made and said we should rejoice and be glad in it. Lord, we pray, O God, that you inspire us even as we meditate on your word this morning. May your Holy Spirit open our eyes and grant us deeper understanding to know and assimilate your word, so that this day your word will be a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Today is Friday, 12th July 2019. The topic for today's daily devotional is "Come Nearer." The Bible passage is taken from the book of Psalms 31 from verse 1 to 24. I read, "In thee, O Lord, do I put my trust. Let me never be ashamed. Deliver me in thy righteousness. Bow down thy ear to me. Deliver me speedily. Be thou my strong rock, for an house of defense to save me. For thou art my rock and my fortress. Therefore, for thy name's sake, lead me and guide me. Pull me out of the net that they have laid privily for me. For thou art my strength. Into thy hand I commit my spirit. Thou hast redeemed me, O Lord, God of truth. I have hated them that regard lying vanities, but I trust in the Lord. I will be glad and rejoice in thy mercy, for thou hast considered my trouble. Thou hast known my soul in adversities, and hast not shut me up into the hand of the enemy. Thou hast set my feet in a large room. Have mercy upon me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. Mine eye is consumed with grief, yea, my soul and my belly. For my life is spent with grief, and my years with sighing. My strength faileth because of mine iniquity, and my bones are consumed. I was a reproach among all my enemies, but especially among my neighbors, and a fear to mine acquaintance. They that did see me without fled from me. I am forgotten as a dead man out of mind. I am like a broken vessel, for I have heard the slander of many. Fear was on every side. Why they took counsel together against me, they devised to take away my life. But I trusted in thee, O Lord. I said, thou art my God. My times are in thy hand. Deliver me from the hand of mine enemies and from them that persecute me. Make thy face to shine upon thy servant. Save me for thy mercy's sake. Let me not be ashamed, O Lord, for I have called upon thee. Let the wicked be ashamed, and let them be silent in the grave. Let the lying lips be put to silence, which speak grievous things proudly and contemptuously against the righteous. O, how great is thy goodness, which thou hast laid up for them that fear thee, which thou hast wrought for them that trust in thee before the sons of men. Thou shalt hide them in the secret of thy presence. From the pride of man, thou shalt keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues. Blessed be the Lord, for he has showed me his marvelous kindness in a strong city. For I said in my haste, I am cut off from before thine eyes. Nevertheless, thou heardest the voice of my supplication when I cried unto thee. O, love the Lord, all ye saints, for the Lord preserveth the faithful and plentifully rewardeth the proud doer. Be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your hearts, all ye that hope in the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Brethren, this morning, the topic says, come nearer. Our God is a God that loves us so much. He loves us beyond human understanding. The love of God is inexplicable, is transcendental. And God is making a call this morning to come nearer to Him. Because when you draw nearer to God, He will draw nearer to you. He is a loving Father, a caring God, slow to anger, merciful, full of compassion. Wonderful is His name. Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father. Who is like Him? Nobody can be compared with Him. Heaven is His throne, and the earth is His footstool. In the passage, the psalmist began this psalm with a plea from God and ended with praise. It is obvious that the psalmist knew God in a very personal way before he got into the crisis that led to the psalm. He understood that without God, he could not win even the smallest battle against his enemies. He was content to allow God to direct his steps. His prayer reveals that in time of deep trouble, we can hide in the shelter of God's presence. In other words, the name of the Lord is a strong tower in which the righteous runneth and become safe. A great assurance was given to us in Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3, as it is written, call to me, and I will answer you, and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. Observe the expression in verse 5. Let me repeat it. Into thy hand I commit my spirit. Thou hast redeemed me, O Lord God of truth. This is part of the seven words of the cross that Jesus mentioned. Into thy hands I commend my spirit. David was in spirit to prophesy that which is about to happen and that which has already taken place, because Jesus has come, he has died on the cross, has been buried, he resurrected, he arose and ascended into heaven, and we are expecting his second coming. I don't know how you are preparing. You need to come nearer to God to feel his presence, to appreciate his goodness, so that the time you spend with God, even if it is 1 second, is more than 1,000 years spent outside God. As the fish cannot survive when they are removed from the waters, so much more man cannot survive when you are removed from the presence of God. Because we are fearfully and wonderfully made in the image of God and after his likeness. So that likeness of God is there for you. The image of God which we represent needs constant renewal, constant fellowship, constant worship in his presence so that you continue to walk according to his precepts. Into thy hand I commit my spirit. This shows complete trust in God. Jesus also used this word while he was on the cross in Luke chapter 23, verse 46. We should commit all to God. Our possessions, our families, our vocations, above all, our lives to him. It is very important, very, very essential. God has not changed. If you live in obedience to him, he will be your rock of refuge and will never allow you to be put to shame. Somebody shout hallelujah. Keep on trusting him to rescue you from any challenge you are facing in this life. Don't allow your problems to make you to undermine the trust you have in God. Rather, tell your problems how big your God is. And when you confront your problem with how big your God is, you will look for that problem, you will not see it again. Because our God is a miraculous working God. He said, signs and wonders will follow the children of God. So when you follow God, signs and wonders will begin to follow you. You don't need to pursue signs and wonders. You just need to follow God. He said unto Abraham, walk before me and be perfect. And that will show you what I will do. Great and mighty things I will do through you. And Abraham believed God. It was counted for him as righteousness. May you come nearer to him this morning. He is equally making a call in Matthew chapter 11, verse 28. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. I will give you rest. Take up my yoke, because my yoke is light. So many persons doesn't want to serve God again because they feel that the burden is too much. Bring your burden to the Lord and he will give you his yoke, which is light. Because the devil's yoke is heavier than the yoke that Christ gives. His own is light. He understands you. He will not allow temptations beyond your capability to come your way. And any temptation that comes your way, he will give you insight. He will give you strength. He will give you courage. He will give you the power to overcome them. He said, who is he that overcometh the world? But he who believes that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Even our faith, that is what you need in this present dispensation, in this world that we find ourselves. May God help us and may God give us the courage, even as you go out this morning, go in the power of the Lord to proclaim he who brought you out of darkness and ushered you into the marvelous light, so that as you shine, you will be an epistle that others will read, and your life, your words, your speeches will bring souls to God. And kingdom of God will continue to rejoice over you. Be happy, be glad, be joyful. Don't be dismayed, don't be discouraged. Keep on keeping on. Shine like the light, because the light of God is shining upon you this morning. Fear not, follow after him, and you can never miss your way. God bless you and have a wonderful day. Prayer. I put my trust in you, O Lord. Let not my enemies triumph over me. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning. We ask, O God, that you continue to lead us. We pray for our nation, Nigeria. May the leaders come to know you. May they follow after your precepts, so that all things will work together according to what in Romans chapter 8, verse 28. We will pray even for our church leaders, our primates, our archbishops and bishops, all the clergy, the entire Church of Nigeria, Anglican Communion, and other faithful that are watching this program. Oh Lord, we pray that you bless them beyond their understanding, beyond their expectation this morning and this weekend, in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. We equally pray for the Diocese of Idato and Oji River, who are celebrating their 20th year anniversary of inauguration of their various dioceses. We pray for Archbishop Madoma and Bishop Mado. Father, we pray, O God, that you continue to be with them. We thank you, Lord, for the consecration anniversary, 10th year anniversary of the following bishop: Bishop Ayu Ode, Bishop Maduike, Bishop Olumakaye, Bishop S.O. Adekunle, and Bishop Kolo, who are celebrating their 10th year anniversary. Father, may these our fathers in the Lord continue to do mighty things in your name, and may you bless their various dioceses. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
We thank you for fellowshipping with us today. We invite you to join us tomorrow morning, same time, same station, for another special edition of the Daily Fountain. If you are led to sponsor or support this program, please contact the numbers and email all showing on your screen. Also, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/ACNNTV. Visit our website www.acnntv.com.